Hi everyone, welcome to Chemicals Academy. So let's discuss some chemical tests which are used to distinguish between aldehydes and ketones, reducing sugars, etc. So first question, iodoform test is not given by 3-pentanone, 2-pentanone, acetaldehyde, ethanol. So what is iodoform test? It is used to check presence of carbonyl compounds with RCOCH3 and alcohols with RCHOHCH3. So the compounds which contain this structure RCOCH3 and alcohols with RCHOHCH3 will give iodoform test. And the result of iodoform test is pale yellow color precipitate, that is CHI3. So CHI3 is the precipitate, yellow precipitate we get in iodoform test, positive result. So the question is 3-pentanone. So first one, 3-pentanone. So the structure of pentanone, CH3, CH2, CO, CH2, CH3. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 3-pentanone. Next one, 2-pentanone. CH3, CO, CH2, CH2, CH3. Next one, acetaldehyde. CH3, CHO. And the last one is ethanol. CH3, CH2, OH. So from these four options, the structure which does not have RCOCH3 or RCHOCH3 is first option. So the answer is A, 3-pentanone. Look, CH3, CH2, CO, CH2, CH3. So CO is there, but next to CO there is no CH3. So here in second option, CO, CH3, CO, CH3. Next one, CH3, CHO. CH3, CHO can be written like this, CHO. So, CO, CH3. And here also, this is the only primary alcohol which give iodoform test. Here, CH3, CH, CH, OH and a H. So, CHOH. So, this will give iodoform test. But in 3-pentanone, it does not give iodoform test. So the answer is A. Second question, monosaccharide does not react with Tollens reagent, sodium bisulfite, acetic anhydride, hydroxylamine. So we have to look on the four options and the reaction with these options with monosaccharide. This one, Tollens test. It is also called silver mirror test that we use in our lab. It oxidizes aldehyde to acid. So Tollens reagent can oxidize aldehyde to acid and the result is a silver mirror in the test tube, silver precipitate. So ketones does not give this reaction, but alpha hydroxy ketones is exceptional. Alpha hydroxy ketones can give Tollens reagent test. And what is Tollens reagent? Ammonical silver nitrate solution, AgNO3 plus NH3 plus NaOH solution is Tollens reagent. Now next one is sodium bisulfite test. It aldehydes form crystalline salt upon addition of aqueous solution of sodium bisulfite. So aldehydes can react with sodium bisulfite to give a crystalline salt. And glucose is in ring form, aldehyde is not free. So the question is about monosaccharides. So in monosaccharides reducing sugars, the aldehyde, the CHO group is not free. So it's in a ring position form. So CHO is not free. So it does not give sodium bisulfite test. Now next one is acetic anhydride. Glucose reacts with acetic anhydride to form pentaacetyl glucose. So monosaccharides can react with acetic anhydride also. Next one, hydroxylamine. Glucose form an oxime with hydroxylamine. Structure CH double bond NCH. Then CHOH 4 times and then COOH. So the question is monosaccharide does not react with So tolerance reagent. In tolerance reagent, reducing sugars, give tolerance reagent. Reducing sugars can give tolerance test. So reducing sugars is monosaccharide. So monosaccharides can give tolerance reagent. Then react with tolerance reagent. Then sodium bisulfite, acetic anhydride, hydroxylamine. So monosaccharide does not react with sodium bisulfite because CHO is not free. Some other chemical tests are biuret test, Benedict test, Molish test, Fehling's test. So biuret test is for detection of peptide bond. So peptide bonds can be detected using biuret test. And the reagent is aqueous solution of potassium sodium tartrate treated with cuprous sulfate and NaOH. Color changes blue to pink purple. So this is important. Blue to pink purple is the color change of biuret test. Now Benedict test. It is test for simple carbohydrates reducing sugars. Alkaline solution of copper to sulfate, sodium carbonate, sodium citrate is the reagent of Benedict test. And the color changes clear blue to brick red. Now third one, Molish test. Check for carbohydrates. It is a test for carbohydrates and solution of alpha naphthol in 95% ethanol is the Molish test reagent and the color changes purple ring. Now last one, Fehling's test. It distinguishes between aldehydes and ketones, monosaccharides, other reducing sugars, alpha hydroxy ketones give positive result. So it's mainly for distinguish between aldehydes and ketones, but reducing sugars, monosaccharides, alpha hydroxy ketones can give Fehling's test. And ketones and aromatic aldehydes does not give Fehling's test. It's very important. Ketones and aromatic aldehydes does not give. So if a question asking benzaldehyde, does benzaldehyde give Fehling's test? Then the answer is no. Fehling solution A is aqueous copper sulfate and Fehling solution B is alkaline sodium potassium tartrate. Alkaline sodium potassium tartrate is Fehling solution B. So biuret test is for peptide bond, Benedict is for reducing sugars, Molish test is for carbohydrates and Molish test is given by all type of carbohydrates. Fehling's test is for distinguish between aldehydes and ketones. So ketones usually does not give Fehling's test, but alpha hydroxy ketones can give positive result.